What's an aimbot?
So with this most recent update, with the whole reticle crosshair changes that you can do, I wanted to make a little guide, kind of. Something a little different, because I get asked all the time, Jenks, what do you do to warm up? How do you get the feels for Widow before you go into a comp and stuff like that? And the honest to God answer is, I don't really do anything. Now, that's not bragging or anything, that's just the reality of things. I know a lot of guys watch Kefri and other PC Widows, and they'll come into the training arena like I'm doing right now, and they'll shoot bots. And a lot of that is for muscle memory and stuff. You don't really need to do that, because, I mean, you're aiming with your thumb. So it's a little bit different. On console, it's more hand-eye coordination, if you ask me, and that's kind of my opinion on it. So with this whole crosshair change, you can get rid of your crosshairs, and that's a great way to warm up. It may sound kind of stupid, but it really helps, and I've been messing around with it, and my shot has been unreal lately because I've been practicing like this. So basically what I did earlier in the day is I played 4 or 5 quick play matches with no reticle. And after I did those matches, I wanted to play a match with my reticle to see if there was a noticeable difference in how I played. And I actually did pretty well with no reticle. Now, you might be wondering, like, how do you know where to shoot? Like, you probably just taped something to your screen or something. Like, no. So I want you to pay attention to when I scope in. When I scope in, look at the center of the scope. There's a square white box that shows up. Did you see it right there? It's like a little diamond. When that square box shows up, that's what I'm looking at when I'm shooting. Like, even on normal games. That means that your charge to your shot has reached 100. So when I'm scoping in and out, in and out, in and out, it's because I'm trying to find that white diamond. So you notice it every single time I scope in. That's center of your screen. So how does this help when you actually use your crosshairs? Well, basically what you're doing is you're trusting no crosshairs. You're using your hand-eye coordination right now to bring the enemy to the center of your screen. That's what you're doing. So when you go into a real game with your crosshairs, those shots are going to be easier. This is a great way to warm up. Like I said, it might sound a little silly to some people, but it genuinely is. Because not only does it get you looking at your little white square for your charge shots, which will help on normal matches with the reticle, but it'll make your shot sharper. It'll be a lot more accurate. It'll be better. How can you make shots with no reticle and then not make a shot with reticle? You know what I mean? So it'll definitely help out. And this mainly applies to console players. I'm sure it could help for PC players, but like I said in the other guides that I've done, I don't really trust doing like bots or playing against AI to warm up. Like, that's more of like a muscle memory thing for PC players, in my opinion. But this is the game where I started using my crosshair. You can see I have the crosshair. I can actually show you. I'll show the setting. I'll show the setting on the crosshair after this, because I tried to replicate the short crosshair. As you guys know, in all my videos, I use the short crosshair. And I found the numbers to imitate that, I guess, to replicate it. It's really similar. It looks really close. But like, you'll notice, like, boom, boom. The shots are just, they're on. They're really good. And like I said, this is the very first game of using my reticle since I did the whole no reticle thing. So, I don't know, man. You guys can be the judge. Maybe it'll help you. Maybe it won't. It definitely helped me to warm up. I'm probably going to start doing this more often, to be completely honest with you. Like I said, I never really did anything to warm up before, but this sure made a difference for me. Plus, it was just a fun little challenge, I guess, because it's kind of unique. It's really tough to do, but it was really fun to do, too. So give it a go, guys. I don't know. Maybe it'll help you out. Maybe it won't. I hope it does. If not, just keep practicing. Your shot will get better in time.